Like, what's your typical morning? What's like the routine?
Usually I come in, like, start the coffee and everything else, slice some tomatoes, onions, and then I get like the paste ready and all that stuff.
Right.
So it usually takes like 45 minutes or so to get all that done. You know, so by the time we open at 6 o'clock, you know, the basic stuff over here is ready, you know, and the bagels are ready too. So by the time everything comes out, we're just good to go.
Come in here.
Oh my god, 9 years.
9 years. What's your usual?
Bacon, egg, and cheese.
And what keeps bringing you back? How come you come here so often?
Great personality. Great people. Great staff.
Thank you very much.
And no, I don't get nothing for free.
What is your day-to-day like?
Day-to-day life?
Yeah.
Bagel store?
Yeah.
Wake up 5 a.m., yell at the kids to get up first, hop in the shower, get ready to leave with traffic, an hour and a half to get here, and then walk in the store and hope to God there's a line to the door. And then the day begins.
What do you think makes this such a staple in this community?
We opened in 1994, me and Jason, and started slow, but it, like, just every year it grew better and better and better.
And when this special? Like, is that the croissant? 2 months that starts back?
3 months.
My name is Jay Goodman. I've been here since day one.
How was that?
What year was that?
I can't remember. Is it 98? It might be 1998. 94.
94. 94, man. 94. How old were you when you started that?
In dog years or? 24?
24. And man, what's kept you going like all these years?
I don't know. It's a pretty good gig, right? You come to work in shorts, sneakers. I don't know. It's awesome. You're doing business, right?
You make
your own hours. It's the best thing in the world.
Every day we make dough, every day Arnold will make bagels, and so the process is making the bagels, we hand roll here, he makes them, lets them proof up for about an hour, puts them in a walking box, And usually you try to bake fresh dough, I would say a day and a half to 2 days later, it's better. You don't want to use fresh dough right away. So we're rolling every day, because thank God we're busy enough that we could do that. And then everything else is, you know, the baker makes the beautiful product after, step by step.
Yeah.
One guy makes a beautiful bagel, one guy bakes a beautiful bagel.
And how many ingredients, or do you know, have estimate, like how many like pounds of flour you go through?
Yeah.
A couple of thousand a week.
Wow.
Back in the days on the boulevard, I landed. We used to kick routines and the presence was fitting. It was I, the abstract,
and me, the 5 footer. I kicks the mad style, so step off the Frankfurter.
Yo, Fife, you remember that routine that we used to make spiffy like Mr. Clean?
A tidbit, a spidgin. I don't get the message, so you got to
okay.
Run the pigeon.
You're on point, Fife.
All the time, Tip.
You're on point, Fife.
All the time, Tip.
You're on point, Fife.
All the time, Tip.
So then grab the microphone and let your words rip.
Now here's a funky introduction of how nice I am. Tell your mother, tell your father, send a telegram. I'm like an energizer, cause you see I last long. My crew is never ever whack because we stand strong. Now if you say my style is whack, that's where you're dead wrong. I slay that body and El Segundo, then push it along. You'll be a fool to reply the Fife is not the man. Cause you know and I know that you know who I am. A special shout out piece goes out to all my pals, you see. And a middle finger goes for all you punkies.
How many bagels do you make?
Many?
How many, yeah?
13 boards.
13 boards. And how many on each board?
35.
So it's been 30 years.
30. Oh, February, March will be 30 years here.
Wow.
Yeah, me and Jay were like 24 and 23 around that.
And what kind of inspired you guys to like do this? And you said how old were you?
20. Put it this way, we both went to college and I guess it wasn't for us.
Mm.
And then we looked into other options.
Right.
There was actually another partner here. It was me, Jay, and another guy, Steve. Steve didn't like the bagel business. He left. Jay took it over. And then it's been me and Jay ever since.
Wow. And how did you guys meet?
We lived in the same neighborhood.
Oh, okay.
Well, same. I was from Brooklyn. We're both from Brooklyn. I was Canarsie. He was Bay Ridge.
Oh, okay.
Ready.
Sausage, egg, and cheese. Plain cream cheese.
Brian had a partner in the beginning before they opened it. They asked me to become a third partner. But I was working in a bagel store in Brooklyn where I grew up, and I didn't become the third partner. They asked me to work here.
Okay.
So I would open the store for them, and then after about 6 months, the other guy wanted to leave.
Okay.
So I bought in after 6 months.
Nice.
I'm here from the beginning, but I'm only an owner all the time except 6 months. So yeah, I went to college, but I don't know. I was working a lot, and it really wasn't for me. I was falling asleep a lot in class, and I'm actually two classes away from, I think, a sports trainer degree and stuff, and education, but it was just too hard because I was they just opened and I was working like 60, 70 hours a week, and I don't know, and I always did this when I was in high school. My job was a bagel store. When I was in college, I worked at a bagel store. I don't know, and it's pretty much the only thing I know, really.
Mm.
So it was pretty easy. Decision was pretty easy.
What are your top-selling items over here?
Bagel flavor-wise or food-wise?
Let's go with bagel first.
Flavor of bagel, nobody beats plain. Plain, then I would say everything of number one and two.
Okay.
Top-selling, cream cheese and butter are still the number one sellers with coffee. And I would say egg sandwiches are definitely up there. Anything egg related.
Bag a nigga cheese. 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 Bag a nigga cheese
my name is Elvis, and I've been here, working here for about 7 years.
You've been doing this 7 years?
Yeah. Man. Roughly.
What do you enjoy about it?
That I finish early.
What were you saying now?
Oh. Yeah, what were some of the challenges? Like,
I think the biggest challenge of this career or job is employees. That's the hardest. To get workers, for a long time it was easy. When it was COVID, it was a little harder. But to get reliable and strong people. Like, right now I have the best staff I've ever had in years.
Three kids, tomato, and a medium pint.
6 8 3 I grab the cash, you touch the cards. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. I can choose a large hot. Large hot, you got it. 975, please. Great. Hey, do best. Give me 1 second. Sir. Oh, sure, no worries. All right, all.
Get ready.
Yep. Yeah, right now, I would say for the last 2 years, I've had an amazing crew where I could, and Jay can take a little more time off and everything, so it's nice. Employee workers are the hardest part to
cream cheese? Jumbo muffin? Okay, I'm sorry. I didn't know what jumbo meant. $7.75, please. Yeah. Have a great day. Thank you.
You too.
Where was I? Yeah, that's the hardest part because when you have a great staff and a strong staff, the customers are happy because they're in and out. They love this, you know, their coffee is ready when they walk in, you know. If they know the face, they walk in, here's your coffee. It's that nice exchange, like the Cheers bar. When you walk in, everybody knows your name. I think that's important. But it also, they work as a team together, where in the past I've had issues. And that just makes it smooth. It makes it enjoyable to come to work.
All the waiters in your grand cafe. Chances, don't ask me why. All your life you had to stand in line, still you're standing on your feet. Oh, all your choices made you change your mind. Now your calendar's complete. Don't wait for answers, just take a chance. Say the human heart is only make-believe. I am only fighting fire with fire. You are still a victim of the accidents you leave. Sure as I'm a victim of desire. You're all the servants in your new hotel.
What time do you come in? What do you typically do? What's like, run through
that
list.
Not that you could tell from my body shape, but I'm at the gym at 4:30.
Okay.
Work out for a little bit, take a quick shower, try to get here by 7.
Mm-hmm.
Leave here around 3:30. Takes me about an hour and a half to get home. And I have 4 kids and a wife, so it's pretty busy.
Oh, man.
I usually cook dinner for everybody.
Okay.
And that's pretty much it.
Oh, you're the cook in the house.
Yeah, that's it.
Nice.
Sleeping by 9:30.
All right.
Not an exciting life, believe me. Far from exciting.
So you're like original New Yorker? Like you were born and raised in New York?
Yes, I was born in Brooklyn. And when I was 26 maybe, I moved to Long Island.
Okay.
And then was married in 98. And yeah, we've been on the island ever since.
Amazing. Yep. So what's the secret to a long marriage then?
A lot of luck. A lot of patience. Yeah. A lot of luck, a lot of patience, finding the right person.
Yeah, amazing.
Yeah, I think it's, I don't even know how it is. You can't do that.
Like, what brings you back here all the time?
It's the history of this place.
Really?
Been around for, what, 20 years?
Yeah.
It's good bagels.
And how long you been coming here?
Probably that much.
Oh, wow. Okay,
yeah,
okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Wow.
From the start.
Yeah. And what do you usually get? What's your usual?
My maple cream cheese and coffee.
Oh, amazing. Amazing. Right. Thank you.
You can figure out the bagel.
Could give yourself advice from, you know, your 20-year-old when you started this off. What's advice would you give them?
Oh, wow. Hindsight. Business has been great. I'm not going to complain about that. I do wish I opened up more stores while I was a little younger. I still want to do one more, I think. I don't know if there's anything else I would do. I mean, you know, being in the city, Wall Street, whatever you want to call it, wasn't for me. It's for other people, I guess. There's nothing I would say. It's been a great run for me.
Nice.
I've enjoyed every, you know, moment in the store, free time that I've had. It's been good. It's been a good run.
Nice.
Yeah.
All right, awesome. Thank you. Gonna be a fun one though.
Okay.
Yeah. So how long you been a Jets fan?
Oh my gosh. My whole life. And now I ruined my two boys' life and my girl's life because I made them Jet fans.
And how did you become a Jets fan?
I guess, I don't know, my dad was watching the game when I was younger. And you know how that works. It's like the first thing you watch, so you're like interested. So you just, I don't know, you get locked in. And it stinks.
And if there's a one thing about a Jets fans people should know about, what is that?
We know how to live in misery.